just like disguise. Bradley is in line with the guest rep.
Thank you so much. I'm here with Dr. Patrick O'Shaughnessy, President and CEO of Catholic Health. Thank you for being here. Congratulations on your first parade. It's your first time as a co-sponsor.
Yes, this is. I'm making my dad proud. It's our first time Catholic Health sponsoring the parade, and we're so proud to be here.
So what drew you to the parade? What made you want to be part of it?
Well, you know, heritage and culture being part of New York and Catholic Health, also being a faith-based health system, it aligns with our faith. And I am Patrick, so St. Patrick, and it's just a wonderful opportunity to connect and give something back. And like they say, you know, everyone's Irish today. So it's great to see a melting pot of so many people come together, having a great time.
We've been talking throughout the day about the theme of food insecurity.
Yes.
And I understand that aligns closely with your mission as well.
Yes, absolutely. You know, we live our mission every day, and it's not just about providing excellence in healthcare, but we give back to our communities. And food insecurity is a real issue. And on Long Island, where we operate, over 200,000 Long Islanders are food insecure. So we contribute to that each and every day. We screen people in our emergency rooms for food insecurity. And if they are food insecure, we provide them to-go bags of food to go home with. And as you know, today's parade, actually the proceeds will go in sponsoring and raising awareness for food insecurity, which is such a major issue.
Tell us a little bit more about your heritage.
Oh my goodness, you can't get more Irish than that, can you? Yeah, so it's interesting. We come from County Galway initially, my dad's side of the family. And actually, Gaelic, our name is O'Shaughnessy. But we're native New Yorkers and we're Americans, so O'Shaughnessy it is. And we're really proud to sponsor the event, proud to be part of this day and celebrating with all of New York.
You belong in this parade. We appreciate it. Congratulations. We hope to see you back next year.
We'll be here. Thank you so much for hosting.
Yeah, happy St. Patrick's Day. We appreciate it. We'll send it back to you.
All right, Randa. Thanks very much. Reminder, being part of the parade is a big thrill for many, many people.
Yeah, indeed, under so many praises, we talked about that. Certainly the one up in the Yonkers tomorrow is a very big one, and I know Mary Fay, Rory Dole, and Patsy Cannon always look forward to generally the Cardinal goes up. Maybe you know somebody from Lizzie Casey, because he always wants to shake hands with Patsy Cannon. And if they get a deal, they kiss the minion up there too, but from that Emmer Mile and up Green Avenue tomorrow.
Fantastic day, and I just saw my friend from Matthew McCartney spending there. We didn't get him, but the Mercedes Coach is marching today proudly. And I have to say hello to Lisa, our daughter, and Sloan and Louise, our little granddaughter. The little granddaughter is listening to the television. She hears that as well, and she's wondering where that is.
See all these different shows, and you know, it's just a connection they all have.
And like when you look at all these schools, you realize that the kid born in New York City, you've got a lot of good choices for education, haven't they?
That's always that classic, you know, you say where you're from.
Yeah.
And the final question is always either what neighborhood or what school you go to.
Yeah. That's
where we find coming from.
Yeah. Don't fail to play back.
Matrix John Devaney. Performed in 2000, they also performed in many events, including the parade today and throughout Central New Jersey as well. And Dublin, they've been in Dublin Island.
Look over there, there's still people on the grandstand, I see. Pat, Carol, and Brianne over there, down from upstairs a little bit. People staying to see all of the parade over there, and they're having a great day. Irish Northern Aid is coming up here right now, and you know, they've been in the parade for many years and is an American-based membership organization that supports through peaceful means the establishment of a democratic 32-county republic. In keeping with the principles of the 1916 proclamation, membership to Irish Northern Aid is open to anybody who shares those values.
Some of the photographers trying to capture several moments of the parade. I think our cameras have probably got the best angle so far.
Yeah, I would imagine so. And we had a new photographer taking pictures of the parade, haven't we? In Australia.
Oh, he's from Australia, Jerry. Jerry Curry this morning. James Curry, not Jerry, James Curry. Someone called him Jerry, but James Curry is his name. His first time fitting in his big shoes to fit, Dominic Tortellino's big shoes to fit, James, but I see that he's doing well today.
All five girls representing Peter Gerlach.
business. I can take care of business up at the office when that goes through. So it's something this parade do. It's very, very worth supporting folks. It takes a fair bit of dollars to put it on the avenue, and the lads who are raising the money, like, you know, Sean Lane and Hillary and all the lads who are running dances and the gala, you know, and I was absolutely incredible. So every dollar counts, every dollar is a part of the parade. So if you would like to donate, just scan it there and the rest will be taken care of. St. Vincent's Nurses, founded in the early 1900s, they're active today.
Yeah, they meet four times a year in January, May, September, November. They have 2,270 members. There you are, hello fellow nurses. Thanks for all you do, and first responders.
We've certainly gained even more additional appreciation for them over the last couple of years, seeing front lines during COVID and what they had to do during that time. They saved countless lives here in New York City.
Yes, thank you for all you've done and are doing every day.
Absolutely.
And there's the Medical Society coming up for them that Jack Greeley is the president, Emily Gallagher is there as well. This was found by a doctor from Dublin, a fellow called James Kelly, and Dowie Lunkin is in. Looking over there, I see Mickey from Anton's out there. Well, we have some at the dinner that we go over there and we stand up with. Joe must be with him,
I don't
know.
Joe and Camilla, yeah, I saw him earlier. I saw Joe and Camilla and Anton's. They're over 75 years old in Anton's and they're treating like kings.
The New York City Parks Department doesn't have to go far to find somebody great here in St. Patrick's Day.
No, for sure.
They are. They're ready to go.
And like, they're so good, Like, when I was in my younger days playing football, they would always let you play football in Gaelic Park. Once you get the permit, it's
yeah.
Amazing. And like, when you talk about that, there's a new Irish football field in out in Queens. And you're involved in it. There are two fantastic fields out there, though. So it's amazing to think that you have an Irish football field in the heart of Queens.
That's right, Shannon Kay. It's right out by the Whitestone Bridge, not far. And then there's a big size field, the standard size field. And all kids from the, as soon as they can walk, they come out and they camogie, hurley, or football. And there's lots of coaches volunteering out there. And Knight Subaru is the chairman there. And Robbie McDonough is a past chairman, and everybody out there working hard.
And I must say a word here because I didn't get a chance to talk in when Westmead went by, but John Dunleavy, who was instrumental in getting me to be Grand Marshal, unfortunately John passed away, and we are definitely in mourning for him. And another past president passed away this week, John O'Connor. That's two men that did a magnificent job for this parade. And while I'm on the subject of Westmead, May 13th, they're going to have a big dinner dance. And I'll tell you one thing, there's going to be a club in the year. The award of lifetime achievement goes to Mike Stone. So that's May 13th for the County Westmead Football and Hurling Club. May 13th for the Young Guy Hurling Club.
Get ready.